Two more returning overseas Filipinos are set to face charges for violating quarantine protocols. So far, two returning Filipinos have already been charged for breaking quarantine protocols. Among them is Gwyneth Chua, who infected more than a dozen people after skipping isolation during the holidays. Meanwhile, the Bureau of Quarantine sees a decline in the number of returning overseas Filipinos testing positive for COVID-19.
Itong partner day po, first time po kami nakakuha ng 200 na nag-positive. So baka po sana tuloy-tuloy sana bumaba na yung trend. So ngayon po, marami na po tayong binuksan ng mga isolation facility within NCR po. Kaya po, naililipat na natin yung mga kababayan na pinag-positive from quarantine hotel to isolation facility po. Apo, karamihan po talaga po is fully vaccinated and with booster dose po yung mga nagpa-positive natin. Kaya nga po, almost 99% ng mga nagpa-positive dahil sa bakuna nila, puro po asymptomatic po.
The COVID risk classification in the Philippines and its capital region have been downgraded. Health Secretary Francisco Duque III says the situation in the country and in Metro Manila went from critical to high risk after a significant drop in the two-week COVID growth rate. This comes a day after Duque said the rise of COVID-19 cases in Metro Manila has already peaked.
Makita natin ang nangyayari. Maganda po ang sa NCR. Talagang mabilis na bumababa. Ganoon din ang plus areas. At nagpaplato ang atin na rest of Luzon. Kung ito mapababa natin ito sa lalong madaling panahon, pwede na po tayong mag-alert level 2 muli sa NCR.
But Duque notes the surge in infections in other regions is still concerning. The Okta Research Group sees the Omicron wave in the country lasting until March or April.
Pero ang inoobserbahan po natin mahigi, binabantayan natin ang Visayas and Mindanao. Pataas po ang mga kaso. So ginagabayan po natin ang mga regions natin, DOH, kasama ang mga DILG and local chief executives na talagang palawigin yung kanilang healthcare capacity, paigtingin ang kanilang prevent, detect, isolate, treat, reintegrate, and vaccinate interventions.
Medyo matatagalan yung yung Omicron wave kasi kahit na medyo bumababa na sa NCR tsaka sa Cavite, Rizal, nagpataas pa lang sa mga ibang lugar at may mga ibang lugar na hindi pa nagkakaroon ng pagtaas . So medyo matatagal ito.
The Philippines logged 24,938 new COVID infections Monday. The tally is fewer compared to previous days, but the level of testing was also relatively lower. Active cases have fallen to almost 263,000 after 35,000 additional recoveries were reported. 47 more patients had also died.
The Philippine Health Department monitoring the sublineage of the Omicron COVID-19 variant, dubbed as a variant under investigation in the UK. The mutation known as BA.2 has been detected in at least 40 countries, but its origin has yet to be determined.
Patuloy na nakikipag-ugnayan sa mga kinatawan ng World Health Organization. Binibigyan tayo ng pinakahuling datos patungkol sa mga katangian ng bagong variant na ito. Pero so far, ang mga limitadong datos nagpapakita, hindi naman ito parang naiiba talaga sa Omicron variant.
The Omicron variant has been detected in about 70% of samples here in the country based on the latest batch of genome sequencing.
The Philippine Food and Drug Administration certifies two COVID-19 self-test kit brands. Abbott Panbio and LabNovation Technologies are the first home antigen test kits to get the FDA's approval in the country. FDA officer in charge Oscar Gutierrez says over 30 more brands are pending approval.
Tandaan po natin na self-testing, isa lang po yan sa measures to protect ourselves and others. Ito po ay isang tools po para malaman natin at maiwasan po natin ang makahawa tayo ng ibang tao.
This development comes as the government's RT-PCR testing labs struggle to keep up with rising demand.
COVID inoculation of minors aged 5 to 11 years old will begin on February 4. That's according to Vaccination Chief Carlito Galvez Jr., who says the jabs intended for the age group will arrive next week. The program will first be implemented in some vaccination sites in Metro Manila before it is expanded to other regions.
Mga ka-assure po tayo, Mr. President, sa ating mga magulang na very safe ang ating gagamitin na bakuna. Dahil ito ay mas mababa ang formulation na angkop para sa mga bata.
The government set to expand its COVID booster rollout in pharmacies nationwide in the next few days. Secretary Vince Dizon, the presidential advisor on COVID response, says he and Health Secretary Duque will travel on Wednesday to Baguio City, where two or more drugstores will be included in the campaign. The popular tourist destination has seen a rise in coronavirus cases recently. Meanwhile, Senator Bongo recommends giving incentives to pharmacies joining the program.
Para mas mainganyo pa yung mga lahat ng mga may-ari ng even private na mga pharmacies natin, talaga mainganyo sila sa pinakamalalayong lugar dito sa Pilipinas, pinakasulok mayor, kasi meron talagang mga ano yan, butika. So mainganyo sila, mas mapabilis ang ating pagpapabakuna. Mas ma-attain po natin yung ating target na ngayong taong ito.
The government also looking to set up more vaccination sites in public transportation hubs. That's after the success of the mobile vaccination drive, which was launched at the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange on Monday. Now, jabs were administered to pre-registered commuters and walk-ins for first, second dose, and booster shots. Authorities are now eyeing to place similar vaccination sites in four MRT stations, namely Cubao, Shaw Boulevard, Boni, and Ayala.
Just by placing this station sa mga strategic area na very convenient sa ating mga kababayan, mas lalong ma-encourage sila magpabakuna ng mabilisan. No? Dadamihan pa po namin ito.
Transport Chief Art Dugade also unveiled plans to put up vaccination sites in seaports and airports.
Ngayon ho, doon sa on-site, meron na sa road, meron sa rail ng tren, sa mga estasyon, at meron din ho kaming ginagawa sa air. Ito yung Terminal 4, nag-set aside kami ng lugar doon na kung kinakailangan, magiging vaccination facility sa paliparan. Meron din ho mga vaccination facility sa North Harbor.
The mobile vaccination initiative began after the implementation of the controversial no vaccine, no ride policy.
The Philippine Health Chief objects to a World Bank report that shows the country's COVID vaccine rollout as lagging behind its Asian neighbors. The World Bank sees this and the increased mobility of Filipinos over the Christmas holidays as likely causes of the Philippines' ongoing COVID surge. Health Secretary Francisco Duque III points out even nations with high vaccination rates still experience infection spikes. Duque also cites how December's Typhoon Odette delayed vaccinations in the provinces hit by the storm.
Hindi ko alam kung saan nila pinulot yan. We can refute this analysis being offered by the World Bank. Sila nga mismo ang manufacturer ng mga bakunang ito at despite that, ang taas ng kanilang vaccine coverage, 70-80, iba 90%, yung iba nagpo-fourth booster dose na nga. Pero kita mo naman, sobra pa rin taas ng kanilang mga kaso, sumisipa pa rin. So hindi naman yun necessarily connected.